action. All right, Jonathan, welcome along to Green Jersey Cycle Tour's first ever armchair ritual interview. congratulations on the Tour Aotearoa.
Thank you.
It is the most exciting cycle race I've followed.
I don't know what to do with that, you know, because you just call it
Cycle event. It's not a race. No, well, I actually had written here race or event.
Yes.
It's pretty exciting.
It's an event. It's not a race, all you people out there in YouTube land.
People seem to be going suspiciously fast, though.
They are. Yeah, people can treat it as they want, but it's an event. People are just cruising along, meeting other people,
just a little bit earlier that you're pretty much treating it as a cafe stopping hopping exercise, stopping at pretty much every cafe that you're coming across.
Yes.
Being here in Martinborough, there are a lot of cafes. How do you choose them?
Well, I knew that there were really good scones from one particular cafe, so I went to those scones. And then I saw that there was some cafe riders in another cafe, so then I had to go across that and test that one out.
It's confusing.
Well, it's amazing that Martinborough is so many cafes.
It's like cafes. They're amazing cafes. Did they have food? That's
sufficient. They did, but that's probably just, that's nothing. The Brevet riders are well spread out now. The Brevet riders all descended on Martinborough in one pit. I don't think Martinborough could handle it.
There's a challenge for Martinborough. I think you could handle it. Little tip for those that are going to be coming through in the middle of the night, Kitchener's Cafe is open from 2 o'clock in the morning.
2 o'clock?
Oh yeah, so you can catch your breakfast there any time of night, almost. Alright, today, what has been the most challenging or difficult for you? You've had a few complaints about the weather.
No, it's not been a problem today. No? Well, we started off with a 4 kilometre an hour northerly from Martin. So we had a 4 kilometre an hour northerly pushing us ahead. And now look at that flag over there, we're going to have a tailwind.
Okay, bearing in mind it's not a race, so we've got Ollie Waller, Jacob Roberts,
yes.
Third player, Seb Dunn, and McDonald. I mean, it's been really awesome watching Anya and Ollie up the front, what they've been achieving. Incredible. And then all of a sudden, Seb appears out of nowhere.
Well, actually,
Seb's
been
in
the lobby. You have to zoom in a lot on the website to check that there is a rider sitting on the one rider's name sitting on the
other
one. Sometimes he goes to but they've been working together for 2 years.
Now, you are one of the most relaxed and together sort of people I've met. You always seem to be in control of things. But this morning, we did seem a little dazed and confused. It might have just been the huge variety of cafes that you had to choose from. Even though you had a luxurious 8-hour sleep.
was actually confused by the variety of cafes, and I was having difficulty deciding which cafe to go into, because Joe had gone to one cafe, there were two other riders in another cafe, and you were going to another cafe, and it was like, shit, which cafe do I go to in this place?
One cafe and a broken kitchen.
Oh no!
We won't mention any more names of cafes, don't want to.
So you just got me for a momentary cafe confusion.
Okay. I was concerned it was the impact of a bit of fatigue. And I wondered, it is a long distance, long distances. What tips do you have?
When it gets to the point where I'm really feeling a bit tired, I just pull out and go to a cafe. And you know, yesterday I went to a cafe and had lunch, and then I went to a so you know, putting on easing it up is difficult because there's a lot of bikes, you're burning all those cars and cars, and it's hard to get that control. So I'm using twice as much as I would normally eat. I'm really enjoying it. My first meal was my sand smell. It came up at night while being starved. I went straight to the campground. I bought a can of spaghetti and sausages and tuna. I opened both of them and then made them both cold. But they were pretty tasty. So if they're riding and they're getting to the point where they can't hold a relaxed conversation with each other, then they know there's something wrong and it's something
wrong. Everyone that we've seen come through, I mean, they're very determined, but they've been able to give us a big smile and a wave, so I think they're all lovely.
Yeah, which is great.
Okay, I've got a question for the preteens. What's your favourite colour?
Blue.
And what cause or organisation are you sponsoring or supporting the ride?
That's an interesting question, because I guess the main organisation project run, there was no entry fee for this event. Everybody gave a donation in the middle of the entry fee. And then some people on top of that chose a particular cause and raising money, so it was almost sort of a big kilometre that they arrived. I don't have that, but I do have a goal to write a book at the end of this. I'm hoping to use that money for that, which is a forest carbon book in South Island.
No, I think that most people will see this. You know, this book, and, I think it's awesome.
Okay. Your parents live in the North Wales.
No, they just